Here we are in Premiere. I have two videos on the timeline, and the first thing we should do is to nest these videos separately so that we can easily change the videos if we need to. So let's right click on the first video, select nest. I'm going to call this one number one, then right click on the second video, nest number two. Then move the time indicator to the point of the cut between the videos and move 10 frames to the left. Then we need to make a cut over here. So I'm going to select the eraser tool, make a cut, go back to the selection tool, then select this piece that we've cut, head over to the effect controls panel, and under the opacity, select the free draw Bezier tool in order to create a mask. Now I'm going to zoom to 50%, so we zoom out slightly, and create a triangular mask, one point in the bottom left corner, then all the way across to the top right, then top left, and make sure you connect the mask at the end. After you've created the mask, make sure in effect controls you set mask feather to 0. Then we need to duplicate this piece, so hold the alt key on the keyboard, left click and drag it one track up, then select the duplicated sequence, and in effect controls make sure you check inverted under the mask, and also set mask expansion to -1 pixel to remove a tiny gap that might appear between the videos. After that, we need to nest these layers separately once again in order to apply transform effect to them. So right click on the first one, nest. I'm going to call this one left since this is the left piece. Then right click on the other one, nest, and call this one right. Now we're going to open effects and search for transform. It will be under distort, and I'm going to drag this to the left and to the right layers. Now let's select the left layer first. In effect controls, let's find transform, and then we need to create a keyframe for position at default value at the start of the layer. Then let's move a bit forward, not all the way because we want to see what we're doing here, and set position values to 0, 0. That should put it all the way to the top left corner of screen. And let's move this keyframe to the end of the layer. Then also make sure you uncheck use composition shutter angle, this one, and set shutter angle to 180 to add motion blur to the transition. Now let's do the same with the other one. Select the right, go to effect controls, make sure you are at the start of this layer, create a keyframe for position at default value, then move forward and double these values. And those values should be the total size of your sequence. In my example, it is 1920 by 1080. And if you're working in 4K, you should put 3840 by 2160. And same goes for any other resolution. And make sure you move this keyframe all the way to the end. Then uncheck use composition shutter angle and set it to 180 to add motion blur. And now before we do the preview, we need to select both of these layers and move them one track up. And then move number two all the way to the left to fill in this gap. And now if we do the preview, we should have this nice split screen transition. And the reason why we nested the videos separately at the start is because, let's say now we don't like these videos, we want to use different ones. So this allows us to simply double click on the number one, and here we have the video. So if we want to use a different one, we just select this, delete it. And now let's say I want to use this video instead. You don't even need to adjust the duration of the video, just leave it as it is. Go back to the main sequence, double click on the number two now, delete this video, add a different one, then go back to the main sequence. And now if we do the preview, we have the exact same transition but with two different videos. So that's how easy it is to change them. And that is it for this one. Thank you guys for watching.